G'day everybody, welcome back to another Affinity photo tutorial. This week I'm going to create this double exposure look using a clipping mask and a few other little tips and tricks along the way. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. So as usual, let's get started. We'll start off by getting rid of everything we've done up here so far, and we'll hit the delete, turn on the background layer as usual. Now I've got this model here, and I've also got this picture of New York City. Both of these pictures, as usual, are from Unsplash, and I will link them below. So the first thing we're going to do, everybody, is we're going to make a selection of the model here, and we're going to use our selection brush tool over here, clicking on it. We're going to make our brush a little bit bigger. I'm using my right and left bracket keys just to resize that brush. And we're just going to make a selection around the model here, and we'll do it as quick as we can. We can always go back and fix it up a little bit as we go. Okay, so I'm going to make my brush a little bit smaller just to go in and fix some of these selections. I'm going to hold my option key down, and that's going to let me go from add to subtract. So we are just going to refine those little bit of selections using the option key around the hat here. And I want it a little bit closer. We don't need all that hair on there. And as you can see, we've got a few little areas that we need to get really in close. I'm just going to make my brush a lot smaller again and just retouch those areas as best we can. Again, using my option key. Again, using my option key and a small brush to get into these little small areas here as well. Nice and easy, a little area here, and using my option key just to get into this area here, holding option down. So using add and subtract. Okay, everybody, well, I'm happy with that selection. Just take a little bit of time with your selection, because the more accurate you are, the better your photo is going to look. Next thing we are going to do is come up here to our refine. So we're going to refine our selection. It's going to put a red color around the selection here, and it gives us an opportunity to have a look to see if there's any areas that we want to actually just get Affinity Photo to take a second look at. Okay, I'm happy with the way it is, but if there was any areas that you wanted it to take another look at, you just need to paint over that area. Affinity will take another pass at it. Okay, once we're happy with our selection, we'll come over here to our refine selection pop-up box. And we're going to come down to the bottom here where it says output, and we are going to change that to output new layer with mask. This is where a little bit of magic happens here. When we hit apply, it does exactly that. It gives us a new layer with a mask, which is really, really awesome. And as you can see, there are a few areas on this photo that could do with a little bit of a tidy up. If you wanted to do that before we continue, you can get your erase tool here, nice small brush, and you could just go around and fix some of those areas up. And again, I would say for you to do that, the more time you spend doing the little bit of tidy up here will make your photo look a lot better. The other thing that we can do as well is click over here on our new layer. We can come up to filters, blur, Gaussian blur, and we could just add a little bit of blur. Okay, apply that. Okay, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to fill this area that's been cut out. We're going to fill it with white. So I'm going to come down here and add a new pixel layer. Actually, I want the pixel layer to be just under the mask here. We'll come over here to our fill tool. We're going to make sure that we're going to fill in white, and once we come over to here, we're just going to fill that background with white. So once we've filled our selection here with white, and come back here to our model layer, and I'm going to just put a curves adjustment on that one, and I want to darken the model a little bit. So I'm just going to come straight here in the middle on our curves. I'm just going to pull down. You can see it's just darkening that a little bit. And you can just do this to your preference. But okay, that looks pretty good. Now we're ready to bring in the photo of New York. So we're going to come over here to the New York layer, and we're going to go Command C, and over here to the model, and Command V. We've got our New York layer here. I'm just going to reduce the size a little bit using the Command and Minus. Over to our Move tool. We're just going to move our New York photo in place. A good way to see where you want to have the photo is just to turn the opacity down a little bit so you can see through. And I'm just going to move that. I'd like to have the building sort of in the top of the hat here. Once you're happy with that, that's fine. You can use your command plus to make the photo big again. Now, this is where the next little bit of magic happens. We're going to take this background and we're going to create a clipping layer. So we're going to drag the background and we're going to move it down here onto the mask. So just click and drag it down onto the mask. So you can see it's just right under the mask there, and then just drop that on there. And you can see already that it's created that clipping mask, which is really, really good. The next thing I'm going to do is keep on that background layer. I'm going to add a mask to that background layer. And this is where we can bring the features of the model back through. So clicking on the mask, over to our paintbrush tool, going to make sure we're painting in black. I'm using a flow of 16% for this, an opacity of 85%, and a hardness of 0. And I like to use a fairly big brush, so I'm going to just make my brush fairly big using my right and left bracket keys. Again, make sure you're painting in black. I'm just going to go over and paint those features back in without losing the background of the city. I'd like to get the hair in there as well, and the hat a little bit. If you think you go too far, you can always hit X on your keyboard, painting back in white, and just go back over it again if you think you've done too much. I like to really bring out the emphasis of the hat here on the model. So just keep doing that to your liking, sort of quite nice. I like the way the city is faded in the background here. And once you're happy with that, there's one other little thing we can do, and that is we can actually just make the model black and white and the city stay in color. So let's have a look at that. So we will come down here to our adjustment layer and hit black and white. And we're just gonna drag the black and white under the background layer here, and as you can see, the model has gone black and white and the city behind her has stayed in color. And you can do some more adjustments to that if you like, or you can skip the black and white step and just have the color. So everybody, that's how you create this double exposure look with a clipping mask in Affinity Photo. If you did like this tutorial, please give me a thumbs up, please consider subscribing to my channel. Also, guys, please drop me a comment down below. I love reading all the comments, and I try to answer every comment that somebody makes. If you have any suggestions or anything that you would like to see in another tutorial, please definitely let me know in the comments below. But until next week, guys, I'm going to say to you, be brave, go out and do something amazing, and I'll see you in the next video.